you is not an annotated bibliography, it is not a list of unrelated sources, and it is an argument about the importance, it is not an argument about the importance of your research. Rather, literature review is an examination of the research that has been conducted in a particular field of study. Hart in 2003 agrees with this notion, but expanded its definition to the selection of available documents and the effective evaluation of these documents in relation to the research being proposed is literature review. Now, we shall see what literature review identifies. Literature review identifies connections, contradictions, and gaps in the literature. The connections let you get a feel for the agreed academic opinion on the topic. The contradictions showcase the disagreements on the topic, and the gaps give you an opportunity to develop and express your own opinions. So the gaps also identify the areas that need further research. The main sources from where literature can be searched are magazines and newspapers, electronic database, books, journals, conference papers, theses, encyclopedia and dictionary, and research and other reports. The third step of research process is formulating hypothesis. Now, what is hypothesis? Hypothesis is an assumptions or predictions of outcome that is testable. If any prediction or assumption is not testable, it is not hypothesis. Now we shall see the details of hypothesis. A hypothesis is a formal tentative statement of the expected relationship between two or more variables under study. A hypothesis helps to translate the research problem and objectives into a clear explanation or prediction of the expected results or outcomes of the study. Hypothesis provides clarity to the research problem and research objectives. It describes and explains or predicts the expected results or outcome of the research. It indicates the type of research design. It directs the research study process. It identifies the population of the research study that is to be investigated or examined, and it facilitates data collection, data analysis, and data interpretation. The characteristics of hypothesis are: a hypothesis must be capable of verification, that means it must be testable. A hypothesis must be related to the existing body of knowledge, and hypothesis needs to be precise, simple, and very specific. Dear learners, now we shall see different types of hypothesis. Here, there are 7 types of hypothesis, such as simple hypothesis, complex hypothesis, empirical hypothesis, null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, logical hypothesis, and statistical hypothesis. Now we shall see the details of these types of hypothesis. Simple hypothesis. Simple hypothesis is that one in which there exists relationship between two variables. One is called independent variable or cause, and the other is dependent variable or effect. For example, smoking leads to cancer. Here, smoking is independent variable, cancer is dependent variable. Complex hypothesis. Complex hypothesis is that one in which as relationship among variables exists. In this type, dependent and independent variables are more than two. For example, smoking and other drugs lead to cancer, tension, chest infection, etc. Here, smoking and other drugs, these are the independent variables, and cancer, tension, and chest infections, these are the dependent variables. Empirical hypothesis. Empirical means it is based on evidence. In scientific method, the word empirical refers to the use of working hypothesis that can be tested using observation and experiment. An empirical data is produced by experiment and observation. Question form of hypothesis. It is the simplest form of empirical hypothesis. in simple case of investigation and research are adequately implemented by resuming a question. For example, how is the ability of 9th class students in learning moral values? Null hypothesis. Null hypothesis simply means no difference. The hypothesis says that observed difference is entirely due to sampling error. That is, it occurred purely by chance. It is denoted by SO. The main purpose of null hypothesis is the test of significance. Null hypothesis is postulated to establish the basis for calculating the probability that the difference occurred purely of chance. Alternate hypothesis. The alternate hypothesis denoted by H1 or HA is the hypothesis. It is the hypothesis that sample observations are influenced by some non-random cause. Statistical hypothesis. A hypothesis which can be verified statistically called a statistical hypothesis. The statement would be logical or illogical, but if statistic verifies it, it will be a statistical hypothesis. Directional hypothesis. Directional hypothesis predicts the direction of the relationship between the independent and dependent variable. For example, high quality of nursing education will lead to high quality of nursing practice skills. Non-directional hypothesis. Non-directional hypothesis predicts the relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable, but does not specify the directional of the relationship. For example, teacher-student relationship influences students' learning. Causal hypothesis. Causal hypothesis predicts a cause and effects relationship or interaction between the independent variable and the dependent variable. This hypothesis predicts the effect of the independent variable on the dependent variable. Associative hypothesis. Associative hypothesis predicts an associative relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable. When there is a change in any one of the variables, changes also occurs in the other variable. The fourth step of research process is preparing for research design. Research design refers to a scheme or plan of action for meeting the objectives. It is a blueprint for conducting a study that maximizes control over factors that could interfere with the validity of the findings. So the researchers plan how the study will be conducted, type of data that will be collected, and the means to be used to obtain these data, which are determined after variables are identified and quantified. In research design, we need to identify the types of research we are going to conduct. Now, there are different types of research from different point of view. From application point of view, research studies are two types, pure research and applied research. From objective point of view, research studies are three types. Exploratory research, descriptive research, correlational or explanatory research, or causal research. And from the type of information sought point of view, research studies are two types, quantitative research and qualitative research. Under research design, we shall have to design the sample. That means, who will be the samples, how many respondents will be included in the samples, what will be the population. These are to be identified by using a statistical formula. And sample must be representative of the population. And the next thing which is to be included under research design is instrument design, that is questionnaire design. And questionnaire is to be designed on the basis of the review of literature and also the objectives of the study. And based on it, questionnaire is to be designed. Instrument or questionnaire can also be tested before going to final research. That means a pilot study can be conducted to test and verify the effectiveness of the questionnaire or instrument. Fifth step of research process is data collection. Primary data can be collected through by observation, through personal interview, through telephone interview, by mailing of questionnaires, or through schedules. Sixth step of research process is data analysis. The analysis of data requires a number of closely related operations, such as establishment of categories. These stages mainly include coding, editing, and tabulation of the data. The main purpose of the data analysis and interpretation phase is to transform the data collected into credible evidence about the development of the intervention and its performance. This process includes the following steps: organizing the data for analysis, that means data preparation, describing the data, interpreting the data, that means assessing the findings against the adopted evaluation criteria. Seventh or last step of research process is interpretation and report writing. Researcher has to prepare the report of what has been done by him. Writing of research report includes three main aspects, such as the preliminary pages, the main text, and the end matter. Dear learners, now we shall learn what is a research report. Research report is a completed study that reports an investigation or exploration of a problem, identifies questions to be addressed, and includes data collected, analyzed, and interpreted by the researcher. The research report format mainly consists of three main sections, such as introductory sections, main body of the report, and appended sections or the reference section. Dear learners, now we shall give an overview of different types of research. Research has been divided or categorized into different categories on the basis of different bases. Now we shall see in detail. Research can be categorized based on different aspects, such as purpose, process, and outcome. From the perspective of purpose, research has been categorized into four types: descriptive research, analytical research, exploratory research, and predictive research. These four types of research also can be categorized into three types, like exploratory research, then descriptive research, and causal research. Descriptive research, it includes fact-finding inquiries of different kinds, such as what, why, when, who, how, and all. The main aim of this research is description of the characteristics of a phenomena at present. This research has no control over the variable, only have to report what is happening or what has happened. For description, researchers use frequencies, averages, and other statistical calculations. The methods used by these researchers involves survey method of all kind, including comparative and correlational method. The periodic table categorizes the elements is an example of descriptive research. Exploratory research. An exploratory design is conducted about a research problem when there are few or no earlier studies to refer to. The focus is on gaining insights and familiarity for later investigation or undertaken when problems are in a preliminary stage of investigation. Gathers preliminary information that will help to define a problem and suggest a hypothesis. It commonly uses unstructured interview. It involves generation of new ideas and assumption, development of tentative theories or hypotheses, but conclusions cannot be drawn even though it provides direction for future research and techniques. Causal research is a research that is conducted to identify the cause and effect relationship between two types of variables, independent variable and dependent variable. For example, if we are interested to identify the relationships between the satisfaction of garment workers at work, then we can identify some independent variable, and then we can identify the impact of those independent variables on dependent variable. For example, satisfaction of garment workers of Bangladesh is the function of workload, then working environment, then supervisor's behavior, then the salary itself. So there might have a number of factors that may have impact on the level of satisfaction of the garment workers of Bangladesh. When the relationship between these two variables, two types of variables, that means dependent variable satisfaction and independent variables, that means the workload or working environment or supervisor's behavior or salary, when these relationships are identified, then that relationship is, that research is called causal research. From process point of view, research can be categorized into two types, qualitative research and quantitative research. Qualitative research, it is handled with qualitative phenomena that involves quality or kind. The research designed to find out how people feel or what people often think are coming under this research. It is important in behavioral sciences. Its aim is to discover the underlying motives of human behavior through detailed description. The data is in the form of words, pictures or objects and all. Quantitative research, this research is based on the measurement of quantity or amount. It can only be expressed in terms of quantity. Researchers use tools such as questionnaire or equipment to collect data, and all aspects of the study are carefully designated before data is collected. Here, data is in the form of numbers or statistics, and this data is more efficient and able to test. On the basis of outcome achieved, research can be categorized into two types, fundamental or basic research or pure research, and applied or action research. Basic research or pure research is a research that adds new knowledge with the existing knowledge. For example, the researcher of the world are trying to discover the vaccine, COVID, corona vaccine for the human being. So if they can discover a new vaccine, then it will add new knowledge with the existing knowledge. And in that case, this research will be called as basic or pure research. And applied research is basically based on the problem. To solve the problem, when research is conducted, that research is called applied research. Business research is an example of applied research. When business manager faces problem, say marketing problem or other problems, then business manager can conduct research, and that research is called applied research. For example, business manager may see that the his or her sales are declining, but he does not know why. So in this case, manager can go for conducting business research and then can identify the reasons to make the appropriate decision. So this type of research is called applied or action research. Dear learners and viewers, today we discussed how to conduct research. And in discussing this answer of this question, we discussed 7 steps of a research process. And dear learners, I hope that these discussions will be useful for you to understand how to conduct a research. And these discussions will give you an overview of a research. Thank you.